we are going to see Heredity and Evolution, Chapter 9, Part 3, Dihybrid Cross. For dihybrid cross, Mendel took two characteristics such as height and shape. He took a tall plant with round seeds and a short plant with wrinkled seeds. The trait for the tall plant with round seeds are capital T, capital T, capital R, capital R. The traits for the short plant with wrinkled seeds are small t, small r. What is the possibility of the gamete here? It is capital T and capital R. And here it is small t and small r. When both the gametes fuse, we get the F1 progeny. The traits of the F1 progeny is capital T, small t, capital R, small r. That is the plant, that is the tall plant with round seeds. When Mendel self-pollinated the F1 progeny, the traits for the F1 progeny are, we know already that it is capital T, small t, capital R, small r. And what are the possibilities of the gametes here? It is capital T, capital R, capital T, small r, small t, capital R, small t, and small r. To find the possibilities of the traits, we have to make a checkerboard. For that, we have to write the gametes on the sides and then we have to combine both the gametes and we have to fill the boxes. For example, when capital T, capital R combines with capital T, capital R, we get capital T, capital T, capital R, and capital R. When capital T, small r combines with capital T, capital R, we get capital T, capital T, capital R, small r. Likewise, we have to combine all the gametes and we have to fill the boxes. And what is the result we have observed? That is, tall plant with round seeds are in the ratio 9. Tall plant with wrinkled seed are in the ratio 3. Short plant with round seeds are in the ratio 3. Short plant and wrinkled seed are in the ratio 1. So we have found that tall and short and round or wrinkled characters inherited independently. That's why new combinations of plants are able to seen. For example, tall with wrinkled is a new combination. Likewise, short with round seeds are also new combinations. So by his experiment, he found that the traits are inheriting independently. How do the traits get expressed? The traits, for example, like shortness or tallness of a plant, or round or wrinkle of the seeds. Likewise, how the traits are getting expressed? We know genes provide the information for making protein. It means that gene codes for the information for the production of a particular protein. In a cell, we have nucleus, and in the nucleus, we have chromosome, and chromosomes are made up of DNA. A fragment or segment of DNA is called gene, which codes for a protein. It means that which provides information for making a protein, and these proteins are responsible for the expression of the characters of the organism. For example, consider tallness traits of a plant. How tallness of a plant is expressed? For example, the growth hormone will be there to provide the tallness of the plant. The production of growth hormone depends upon a kind of enzyme. We know that enzymes are the catalyst which helps in the process of making hormones. So when these enzymes act efficiently, ultimately, more hormone will be produced, which in turn results in the tallness of the plant. When these enzyme is less efficient, ultimately less hormone will be produced, which in turn results in the shortness of the plant. Thus, here enzymes which involves in the process of efficiency of making hormone, decide whether the plant is tall or short. Likewise, the protein determines the characteristic of the organism. Interpretation of Mendel's experiment. So, by the Mendel experiment, we can able to know the following facts, such as both father and mother contribute equal DNA to the progeny. So, both father and mother, they are contributing, they are giving equal amount of gene to the progeny. Gametes have half the number of chromosome that of the parent. So, gametes produced from the father or mother is having half the number of chromosome as that of father and mother. When both the gametes fuse, fertilize, the original chromosome is restored in the progeny. Yes, we have seen, no, when the gamete capital T, capital R fuse with capital T and capital R, we are restoring the original traits in the progeny, isn't it? So, when both the gametes fuse, the original chromosome is restored in the progeny. Thus, it ensures constant number of chromosome in the species. By this way only, the constancy of the number of chromosome is maintained in the species. Sex determination in the species. How sex is determined in the species? In some species, the sex is determined by environmental factors. For example, like reptiles, the temperature at which the egg fertilizes will decide whether the egg will develop into a male or a female. Consider another example like snail, which can able to change its sex. But that is not in a case of human, because in human the sex is determined genetically, that is, genes will determine the sex in the human beings. Chromosome number is constant for particular species. It means that for each and every species there is a constant number of chromosome in it. Human consists of 23 pairs of chromosome or 46 chromosomes. Human chromosomes are 46 in number, or else we can say 23 pairs, of which it is divided into two types. They are autosomes and allosomes. Autosomes are otherwise called as body chromosomes, and allosome are otherwise called as sex chromosomes. There are 22 pairs of autosomes and one pair of sex chromosome or allosome. These sex chromosomes are of two types. They are X type and Y type. For female, the sex chromosome are of same type. That is, both the chromosomes for the female, sex chromosomes of the female are of X and X. But for the male, the sex chromosome is of different type, that they are X and Y type. Consider a male and a female. A male will be having the sex chromosome in the form X and Y, and female will be having X and X chromosome. The gamete, that is the sperm, will have half number of chromosome as that of the male. For example, a sperm may carry either X chromosome or Y chromosome, but the female gamete, the egg, always will carry the X chromosome. The sperm containing the X chromosome then fuses with the egg. The zygote will be of X and X. The resultant zygote will develop into a female. When the sperm containing Y chromosome fuses with the egg, the zygote will be of X and Y type, which will develop into a male. So, it is the sperm which carries the X or Y chromosome determines the sex of a human.